Here on Inside Golf Magazine, we are always looking for new ways to improve your golf game, and today is no different. We're here in Carlsbad, California at the Kip Puterbaugh Aviara Golf Academy, and joining me is Golf Magazine Top 100 teacher, Kip Puterbaugh.
Hi Jessica, how you doing?
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So I'd like to talk to you about one of the most important fundamentals in the game of golf, the grip. What is it that you notice most that your students are doing improperly?
We've found out through the years that you need to have your hands on the club properly, but most amateurs are way too tight and tense, and one of the reasons they get tense is because the clubs get either too slippery or too hard, and they can't hold on a club correctly, so they start adding tension. So we try to make sure the grips are soft and relatively good shape so they don't have to choke to death.
Now, I know another important factor to consider is equipment. Do you notice that your students are often ill-equipped with their grips?
Oftentimes, that's the last thing they check. You know, as they stay in the cart in the trunk for too long, they get hard, they get slippery, and they don't wash them, and then pretty soon they're choking their golf clubs.
Kip, you have quite a few students hitting on the range right now. How likely is it that some of them have improper grips on their clubs?
It's pretty likely.
Well, what do you say we look in the bag of one of them and find out?
Let's check with Mike right over here.
Okay.
Hey Mike, how you doing?
Good, how are you today?
We have a special offer here for you today at the Aviara Golf Academy. We have Jessica here from Golf Magazine. She'd like to talk to you about getting a deal for maybe getting some new grips today.
Okay.
Mike, Kip and I have been discussing how players often don't have the right grips on their clubs. And today we have a special deal. Lamkin wants to offer you a brand new set of grips if yours are not working out.
Wow, that sounds great.
Can we have a look at your clubs?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Noticing that your ball flight tends to go to the right, mm-hmm. I think your grips are a little too big, especially in the right hand. The bigger the grip is, the harder it is for you to release the golf club. Plus, they're a little bit hard and they're not very tacky. So I think a replacement of some grips would help you hold on the club without having to have so much tension.
That sounds great. That's what I'm here for, to improve my game.
Well, Mike, if it's okay with you, we're going to take every club out of your bag and put on a Performance Plus 3-Gen grip from Lamkin. What do you think?
That sounds like a great opportunity. Let's do it.
Okay. And to learn a little bit more about the new line of Lamkin grips, let's hear from the president and CEO of the company, Bob Lamkin.
Well, it's amazing to me when I have traveled around, played a lot of golf in a lot of different parts of the country and the world, and it seems to be universal that re-gripping is not relegated to just lower handicap players, better players looking at their clubs and their equipment. It's all over the spectrum. Re-gripping has been overlooked in general. As a game improvement opportunity for players to actually improve the consistency of their game. And I would recommend for players of all levels, if to become more consistent, is to really take re-gripping, and again, I can't emphasize enough, grip fitting into consideration to improve their games.
Earlier on in the segment, Mike received an entirely new set of Lamkin grips. So we immediately sent him out to Aviara Golf Course to play 18 holes and really familiarize himself with the changes that it could make in his game. Mike is here with me now to tell me a little bit about his experience. Now Mike, I know Kip gave you a lot of recommendations. How did it work out?
Well, it worked out really great. They recommended the Performance Plus 3-Gen. It's a really great grip. It's soft, it's tacky, and it gave me confidence, which is really important.
Mike, I know you don't wear a glove, so feel is probably more important for you than it is even for the average player. So what did you think about the feel on these grips?
It felt really good. They were soft, but not squishy like some soft grips are, and it was tacky. So it's very important for me to have a tacky grip while I'm out playing, because like you said, I don't wear a golf glove, so it's very important to have that feel and to be able to have the confidence that I can grip the club.
And how did you feel around the greens?
Very nice around the greens. It was great. Was able to get good feeling and put good touch on my chips around the greens.
So what did you shoot today?
I shot 77. I broke 80. That's my goal every time I go out.
Very nice. Well, if there's anything we've learned here today, it's that everyone can benefit from having the right grips on their clubs.
I agree. You're right.
We thank Lamkin for their help here today, and we definitely recommend that you check your own bag. Make sure that your grips are right for you, and look forward to lower scores.